Hello everyone, today I'm going to make a very famous Indian street food called samosa. It has a very simple recipe of making and with very few ingredients, this is the best recipe for snacks. So let's see quickly what all things do we need to make this simple but best snack. For making the samosas, the very first thing that I'm doing is making its cover. And for making its cover, I'm taking 2 cups of all-purpose flour. In this flour, I am adding 2 tablespoons of cooking oil, 1 tablespoon of salt, and pinch of cumin seeds. And now I'll mix everything together. Now the oil, salt, and the flour, they are mixed together very nicely. I'll add water to it. I will add water gradually and make a soft dough from it. Now my dough is ready. From the top, I'll spread some oil on it and we'll knead it again. So my samosa cover is ready or my dough is ready. I'll cover it and keep it aside. Till my dough is resting, I'll make the stuffing for the samosas. For making the stuffing of samosas, I'm taking 2 tablespoons of cooking oil in a pan. To which I will add 1/2 tablespoon of cumin and mustard seeds. At the same time, I am adding to it 1/2 tablespoon of fennel seeds. Fennel seeds are optional in this recipe. But if you have them, do not forget to add them because they give a very good flavor to the samosas. Once cumin and mustard seeds starts cracking, I will add 1 clove of garlic to it. I will saute it a little bit. As garlic starts getting golden brown, I will add 1 chopped onion to this. At the time I am cooking onions, I will also add a pinch of salt to it. Saute the onions a little bit. As onions are getting golden brown, I will add 1/2 tablespoon of turmeric powder to it. Mix it together. As onions are getting golden brown, to them I will add 1/2 cup of green peas to it. I will saute them a little bit. To this I am adding 1/2 tablespoon of chili powder, 1 tablespoon of coriander powder, 1 tablespoon of mango powder. We'll mix everything together. As the peas are cooking from last 3 to 4 minutes, it's right time to add boiled potatoes to it. For making samosas, I'm taking 3 boiled potatoes and I mash them very nicely. So now adding potatoes to it. Now I will mix them together with everything. Now potatoes are mixed together very nicely with peas and with onions. It's right time to add salt in it. Here I am adding 2 tablespoons of salt. And in the end, I'm adding 1/2 tablespoon of garam masala to it. Some chopped spring onions to it. And now it's right time to mix together everything very nicely. In this way, my samosa stuffing is ready. I will let it cool down for some time and then I'll make my samosas. From last 10 minutes, the dough is resting. It's time to roll it. For rolling the dough, I'll first knead it again. We'll take a small portion of it and make a ball from it. And now I'll roll it. For rolling the dough, you can either spread some flour or you can dip it a little bit into the oil. I spread some oil from the top and now I'll roll it. Now I rolled the dough. It's not necessary that it should be a circle. Now cut it from the middle. Now we have 2 parts of it. Take 1 part of it in hand and fold it like this on one another. It looks like this from outside, and inside we have a small pocket where we can stuff our stuffing. So now I will take the stuffing and put it into it. Do not add too much of stuffing at a time. Now take some water and put it onto the ends. Don't add too much of water. And now join the ends. And our first samosa is ready. And now I will show you one more way of folding a samosa. The very first thing that I did is I rolled the dough. Now I will cut it again from the middle. Will spread my stuffing on this side or this corner of the dough. Do not add too much of stuffing at a time. Take this corner of the dough and put it onto it. Take this side and put it onto the other side of it. And the last corner, take it and put it onto it. In the end, do not forget to join the ends very nicely together. And in this way, your perfect samosa shape is ready. For frying the samosas, I took some oil in a pan. So the oil is perfect. I can dip my samosas into the oil. So till my samosas are frying, I'll make some more. Now the samosas are fried very nicely. I will take these three out. So my very crispy samosas are ready to eat. You can see with perfect temperature, they get a very perfect shape and color also. So do try this wonderful recipe at home. At the same time, do not forget to like and subscribe my channel. Till next recipe.